love you.
That's true. Before we start, I'm going to put on my lead organizer cap and take off my speaking cap and say that we catered for 100 people for the after party. Look around you, do some calculations. 100 people here. So if you have a partner or a friend that's picking you up, or they're waiting for you home and you want to invite them, this is your lead organizer saying, go ahead. Really, go for it. Way too much food. Cool. So, I can pretty much guarantee you that Bruce and I have prepared nothing for this. I can almost get out of an hour ago. I can almost guarantee that. And the reason we prepared nothing is because we're just going to tell you our story. A story of how getting involved in the community made a difference in our life. Do I need to be over here sitting on the camera?
Thanks, John.
This is the story of how I got involved in the community. Okay, so my name is Jonathan Foster. I'm a freelance developer. I spent 50% of my day in WordPress and I spent 50% of my day in my blog. I'm also a WordPress community deputy. I'm a WordPress case meetup organizer along with Chris Pugh. Last year and this year, I was the organizer of WordCat Cater. As you can see here, this is my slides and my notes. My work over here, you can see here. And WordCamp Cape Town 2015 changed my life. It was the first WordCamp I ever went to. It was the first time I discovered that WordPress is not just a blogging tool. It was the first time I discovered this thing called the WordPress community. And at the end of that second day, I made a decision that I was going to choose WordPress, if you will, and make WordPress my very best of my life. And I realized that over the last few years, I've realized that contributing is not about what you do, how regularly you do it, or how much you do. It's just the fact that you do something. One small thing makes all the difference in the world. I remember sitting in a talk in WordCamp Cape Town, I think it was 2016. Constantine Oberland was a speaker, he's a mathematician, and his first contribution was fixing a double underscore in a translation function call. So it was supposed to be a double underscore and it was a single underscore. So he added another underscore and a line, whatever it was. He just added one character and he submitted that patch and he was a core contributor. Just one thing. Okay. And what I've discovered and what I've realized about all of this is that you don't have to be a lead organizer at WordCamp. You don't have to be the finance director. You don't have to do anything more than what you can handle. And it boils down to making a choice. Now, the main reason that Bruce and I are doing this talk is to try and convince those of you who are here today to join us tomorrow for Contributor Day.
You totally should.
Again, it's about the numbers. We have catered for 50 people. So I've got, again, I'm going to take my cap off again, the organizer cap back on. I've got pizza and water coming for 50 people tomorrow at lunchtime. We currently have 16 people signed up. If you want some free, I want to say you're a pizza, if you want some free Coke, Mantis, Pride, pizza, come and join us. Please. Okay? Because the point of contributing is you don't have to be an amazing developer. You don't have to be a core contributor. You don't have to do anything more than just one thing. If you arrive and join us tomorrow and you're going to get there at 11 and you spend an hour and you answer one support ticket and you help one person, sounds familiar from the last time I spoke, and you want support ticket, and you help one person solve a problem, you have contributed. And that's what it says. Okay? The rest of my talk is going to be about my journey and my story, but before I do that, I'm going to hand over to the second sexiest bald man in America, Chris Hunt.
So apparently no one told me about Casual Friday. So this is kind of awkward. So anyway, as you guys know, my name is Bruce. My take on this is slightly different in that my involvement with the WordPress community led to involvement with other communities, which led to a change in career. And I didn't plan on any of this happening, so it's a bit of a whirlwind. I started when I was 14 as a developer. I worked on the ticketing system for a big events company, as well as one of the big cinemas. And then then I did that for 2 years. I then went to KFM and Prime Media and produced their website for a year. I then decided to take a year off so I could matriculate. Then delivering the promo, went back to work. And then I kind of changed. Well, I translated the development space, and I kind of realized I like to work with people, which is weird because I'm actually an introvert. And the mind, that's okay. And I then kind of learned to be a manager. I learned about it. And I joined a small company called Get Spotted as a project management consultant, and then eventually became their IT director. And it was after that I decided I'm kind of done working for someone else, want to be an entrepreneur. So I co-founded a web development agency, and we knew nothing about WordPress. We did massive corporate systems, so custom CRM systems and so on. So after 2 years of doing that, realizing that is terrible, we started doing more and more websites, and someone said, hey, come to WordCamp. So I joined my WordCamp. I think the first one was in 2013. And to be honest, I couldn't care less about the platform. It was you guys. I've never seen anything like it where there were so many people willing to help and to teach you, to train you, and get involved. What's great about this community as well is even as an agency owner, if I had too much work, I knew that I could contact half the guys in this room and say, hey, would you help me with this? They'd happily drop everything and help us out. And it's the same when we have quiet periods and say, hey, sorry, do you have anything that we can do? They'll actually outsource to us. So I really found love with that community. And because of that, and you, John, we started getting involved in running meetups, volunteering at the workouts. And now I've been on the organizing committee with John for your 2 years. Before that, I was with Matt. And then you, so it's been a, I couldn't say no anymore. And on top of that, as you guys know, with WooCommerce and Basic Automatic and everything else, they kind of taught me how to live a digital nomad lifestyle. And we actually shut down the office for our company. We didn't need one. We started, we rather pay people more and let them travel. And that opened up a whole world to me because suddenly, I think within the space of 5 years, we went to 34 countries because I didn't need an office anymore. And then you meet more people, and through meeting those people, your life changes, you learn new things, you grow. And then through that, about 7 months ago, I got a call from the Vice President of Community for Startup Grind. I don't know if you know that. It's the world's largest entrepreneurship organization. He called me up and said, just by the by, hypothetically, if we had a community manager job, would you apply for it? And I had my own agency, I was running it, and I was like, yeah, sure, I dropped everything in a heartbeat. I said, okay, that's interesting. And he called an hour later and said, by the way, the job's yours. So that day, I called a board meeting, and I was like, listen, I love you guys, but I can't say no to this. And because of my involvement with the WordPress community, I was now being asked to help run this massive global community of entrepreneurs. And I had to take it, I couldn't say no. So just without WordPress, without going to that first WordCamp, without meeting one of you other people, I never would have met the startup grind crowd. I wouldn't have inadvertently stepped into a 5-year unplanned job interview, which instantly got me a job on a platform I never could have dreamed of to help literally millions of entrepreneurs around the world. So I have to thank WordPress for that. I've been totally lost without you guys, so thank you.
About a half hour in good traffic. And I said,
I'd like to get involved in starting up a meetup in the North Side. And he said, cool, why don't you join the WordPress Slack, join the meetup group, and if I'm long to a meetup, we can chat about it. Unfortunately, that meetup group doesn't exist yet. Because what happened was I got involved in the Cape Town meetup. In January 2016, Matt Mullenberg did a fireside chat meetup, which I missed. I'm still sad about that. But it was around the time that my youngest was about 9 months old, so leaving my wife alone for an evening to go and chat to Matt and Mullenberg. And I finally went to my first meetup in June 2016. I met the folks. I got to know the people came to me, I was going to give it to Bruce. And I then started getting more involved in the community. For the very next WordCamp, I applied to be a speaker. I don't think I get invited, I really asked to. I applied to be a speaker because I realized that if I want to share what I want to share, I need to step up and make a difference and make a choice. Then I was invited by a local WordPress development company called CodeCamp to be interviewed by them at the end of that WordCamp. And the reason that they said to me that they wanted to interview me, because they were interviewing people like Jeffrey Pierce and Hugh Ashbrook, and people who are veterans of the Cape Town WordPress space. And here I was this newbie. Hardly, I vividly still remember, I think it was Matt asking Hugh, who's this Jonathan guy? Because nobody knew who I was. I wasn't as involved in the community then. And the reason they wanted to interview me, because they found it so interesting that I went to my first WordCamp in 2015 and I was speaking in 2016 already. Well, what is so amazing about me that I'm speaking in the next WordCamp? I said to them in an interview, nothing. I'm just a guy who likes to do things, and this is a space where you can do things, where they welcome people doing things. At the same time, so from the point of choosing WordPress, at the time, I was working as a contractor for a local development company, shout out to the wrong voice because over there. And I worked in business with my wife and trying to manage one son who was very new and contracting on site years a week and running a weekend business and all that was getting crazy, so I left Ron and I went full freelance. And the first year was hard. The first year was exceptionally hard. And then I applied for a company called Code. I'm wearing a t-shirt right now. They are a freelance, a WordPress specific freelance platform. And in my interview, before I was accepted, one of the questions that they asked me was, is how are you involved in the WordPress community? By that time I could go, well, I'm busy with the meetups and I'm speaking in WordCamp, and I applied to lead organize WordCamp next year. They were like, great. Because they already understood the value of this community that I was still discovering. And part of the reason why I ended up at Code, why I leave, is because I was so community oriented. I was involved in the community, I was giving back to WordPress. I applied to lead WordCamp Cape Town for 2017. Because after you finished in 2015, there was another lead who was leading it from 2016 to 2017. I applied for 2018 for the first time. So I applied to lead in 2018. In October 2016, I was asked by you whether I would be able to step in on 2016, because the person who was leading that year had some family issues they were dealing with, and would I be prepared to do it? And I went, yeah, why not? How are we going to be? Boy. So I learned some things, the series not good. And we're here today. I'm finishing up my second year chatting to the interviewers. And the key thing that I want to again drive home is it was I made those decisions. I decided to try these things. So I am a WordPress contributor. I have written this amount of code towards WordPress. I have not done any design, I have not done any testing. It's all been community-based. But because I just got involved in an area where I was comfortable in getting involved in outside of my job, I'm here in a space where I am literally, and I know you're supposed to use literally in the right way, not figuratively or whatever it is, but I literally, in 2 years, doubled my earning potential because I made that choice to go WordPress. Double. I kid you not. And that's working 3 days a week. Okay. I'm now in a situation where my wife has not had enough of working all the years she's working, she has to become a full-time mom, and I feel comfortable enough to say that, don't worry, I've got this. Because I'm involved in the community, because I'm meeting all these amazing clients from around the world, all over the place, and there's a little bit of scope for WordPress-based work, and things outside of WordPress, and learning new things, and growing, and all that kind of thing, I've got this. Because I'm not involved in the WordPress community.
Give back in any way you can.
and I can guarantee you it will be returned to you at least tenfold.
So, running just aside, we're 10 minutes late, so we should do it every night. Maybe that day, we might have time to talk, that's how we go. So the direct impact contributing had to my life. Contributing late, because I can't spell late at night, Hugh to recommend me. It's all about you, man. You need to submit in that. You have a message. Let him to recommend me to the new owner of Social Simple Podcasting, which led him to an almost 2-year position so far as lead developer on Social Simple Podcasting customers. Hugh had not seen a line of my code when he made that recommendation. It was purely based on my involvement in the community. Okay, I could have been a horrible brother. I think he knew that I wasn't because I had presented a talk about your development, so yeah, I didn't know what I was doing. But purely because I was involved in the community when you sold the blade and the new owner said, who do you recommend? My NKR. Contributing to XP being accepted as a global expert was probably one of the key moments in my freelance career. Contributing to XP to travel to WordCamp in Hamburg and WordCamp Europe. I have never been out of this country on my own, 41 years old. I've never been out of this country on my own because I didn't have funds or the opportunity to present myself. I was able to go to Europe for the first time this year. The cast first team is, I think, going to be planning a team to next year to start traveling. Like this man's going to show you now where it was. Where is the need for traveling? It's amazing. I can afford. And not only that, I didn't have to, but I can afford my few masters. So my time is built up. So I can't afford to not work. I've been here for the last 2 years and I haven't listened to work and I'm not worried about it. Contributing is what I need to give back to the project that has directly led to me being able to double my income potential. Okay, if you haven't heard of the concept of buying for the future, Matt Mullery talks about giving 5% of your time back to WordPress. And that 5% can be joining us as a volunteer for the 2 days a week. It can be being an organizer. It can be when I started, I used to run a front. Who here on a Friday afternoon around 4 o'clock, you've had enough to work, you want to go for a room? Okay? Most of us. So what I used to do, I don't get that so much anymore than doing other things. Friday afternoon, 4 o'clock, WordPress.org/support. Find some tickets that have been around that have been answered, and answer some support tickets that I can answer. That's one support, that's 5 support tickets that somebody else doesn't have to do. That's perfectly fine. So whatever it takes. And the point that I'm trying to make is we all use WordPress, and we all make a living from WordPress. And we love WordPress. But if you can start thinking about as much as you can, and I say this as much as we can, so whatever you can, giving back to WordPress, it will have a direct impact on what you're able to do and grow and achieve as you go.
Mine is short and very narrow. So, as I mentioned, it helped us become kind of subject matter experts. And suddenly we were sitting on panels talking about things that 2 years ago we had no idea about. So, definitely, that was really cool, by the way. Thank you very much for that opportunity. This is very important to me. I made friends and not contacts. Okay? A contact, when you ask them for help, they're not really going to do it. A friend will always be there for you. And this community is made of friends, which is very important. Okay? It taught me to live a digital nomad lifestyle. Like I said, I think 34 countries so far in the last 5 years. This year alone, I've been to 13 countries, and I'm leaving again in a couple of weeks for Germany and the Netherlands. I don't even know anymore. And then, as I mentioned, it led to a whole new career path that I've never ever thought of. Community management is kind of my passion, was my destiny, and I had no idea that anything existed as a career path. So that was big for me.
Sorry, I'm just doing all my things. So these are the 5 key things that I've learned about contributing to WordPress. Contributing just requires one thing, I've said this before. The world wants to make a change in the world of WordPress. One of the questions that came along earlier was, is plugin development contributing to WordPress? Yes. You don't have to contribute to the world. If you built a plugin, that's contributing. So the first thing that I've learned is contributors are human beings. We're all human beings. We have lives. We have partners, some of us have children, some of us have more children, they're crazy. We have jobs, we have clients. If you can't do what you want to do this week, you need to push it out to next week or the next week or the next week, that's fine. We are all volunteering. So everything that we do to give back to the WordPress is all our own free time. So people aren't going to expect you to have these crazy deadlines and stick to them. If you follow automatic, one of the automatic creeds is communication is mastered for distributed teams. And that applies to contributing to WordPress. If you tell somebody in one of the teams that you're going to finish this document by next week Friday, and something happens that you can't, then you just tell the team, hey folks, something happened, I can't finish on Friday, I'll do it the next week. And everybody gets it. So it's not like working for a company. And I think that, I know for me at least, when I first started working, I had that if I set the deadline, I have to stick with it. Right? We all know that. In a company, in a volunteer environment, in an open source, bizarre like environment, we all understand, we all get it. When I, this year we organized a team, instead of me being the lead organizer and just applying jobs to certain people, we actually formed smaller teams within the community. And we had team meetings, the Bruce was our finance lead, Hugh was our speaker lead, Matt's team was our digital lead, etc. etc. And I contacted Josette, who's a mathematician and contributed to the project. I said to her, we're doing this new thing, we're doing teams. You manage teams, do you have any advice for me in this volunteer space? And the two things she said to me were, number one, make sure everybody understands that you get that they're doing this volunteer. Make sure they know that it's okay to miss a deadline. It's not really a deadline. You're not dead if you miss it. Okay. Also make sure that when you check in with the teams, you don't say to them, hi there, how's it going? I expect them to give you this feedback. Check in and go, hi there, what can I do to help you? Because then people are more inclined to say, I need help with this. So those are the two pieces of life sharing. Number three, small things can affect big changes. Adding one underscore to a piece of blew my mind when I heard that story. Adding one underscore, one character, testing one part, adding one translation. That's called making a really bad line. Good like translations. But if the reason I haven't done those is because there's more important things than I'm fixing or working on. If I could get a whole bunch of people just come along and add those comments, it would be amazing. And you'll all get props to the way. I'm trying to get you to work on my way. I'm just saying, WordPress is cool, whatever. If it's not fun, you're not doing it right. If contributing to WordPress becomes difficult, you're taking it too seriously to relax. And remember that it's okay. And finally, don't get dragged to the next time you drop. Okay, there is always some drama going on because of how big our community is, right? It's 32% of the top 100 websites in the world. That's a huge amount of
people. 10 million.
10 million, whatever is next week. I want to shout out there, which I asked about. That's a huge number of sites. That's a huge number of people using, building with, selling on WordPress, relying on WordPress to earn their income. Some people are going to disagree with you, and that's okay. Someone needs to tell the president of the US that. So when the drama is happening, don't get sucked in. Take a step back. That's one thing that I learned to do. I take a step back. When somebody says something online that disagrees with how I feel about WordPress, and I say, I'm getting all worked up. Take a step back. And I remember that their experience is important. I try and explain to them why. I try and keep them in the conversation. And the bottom line of all of this is that because we're all human, because we're all.
Fallible,
thank you, Trish. Because we're all fallible, and because we're all just giving to this project as much as we can, it's okay to make mistakes. It's okay to miss a deadline. It's okay to not finish the job where you're supposed to be. But the more people we can get rotated, the more of you that are convinced to join us tomorrow. Yes, this is a sales pitch for tomorrow. Please join us tomorrow. Okay? The more you can get more people to join, and not just join because you want to get them from something else to WordPress, but join because they're using WordPress and I want to explain to them how amazing contributing to WordPress is. Okay, first of all, free pizza tomorrow. Lunch is served, lunch is sorted. Please, I don't want to take pizza home to my kids one more time from the latest pizza. So I come and bring friends, right? But the more we can do that, the more we can be on that same space, the better for everyone.
Let me just say, you've changed a lot.
Well,
I'm good as well. As I mentioned before, like, what I think the WordPress community is, and this is a WordPress conference, what this taught me, what you have taught me, is to get involved in everything that I'm passionate about. So, anything I've learned to do, get involved with communities, not just within WordPress, okay? It's going to have a massive impact on your life. And because you're passionate about it, there's a good chance that you're going to have an impact on someone else's, okay? Number one thing for me, make friends, not contacts. What's great about traveling so much is every single city I've been to, I've met someone in the community in that city that I can meet up with, have a little check with. And, you know, where else can you say that? Like, to meet up with a stranger who's a part of your family, you can just connect with instantly because of a mutual connection. That's amazing. It's about giving, not just taking. And as John mentioned, you know, it's about volunteering, it's about doing what's important. It makes you feel good about yourself as well, because you can go to bed knowing you actually did something for it. Help others before you help yourself, very similar, but especially, in my opinion, the single most important thing that we have to give is time. Yeah. You can make more money, you can get more things, but you can't get your time back. So to actually take some of your time to devote to something, to give it to someone else, that's priceless.
Yeah.
And this was bigger for me, opening yourself up to new kind of teachings and ideas, philosophies, experiences. I never thought I could manage a community. Now I'm doing it. I never thought I'd be standing in front of you folks talking. This is about the second time I'm doing it now. And also, this is a big one. I know I didn't believe you when I said I was an introvert, but I actually really was. And it petrified me to actually talk to people. But you learn to get over it. And it's okay to be scared. Do it anyway. So, we're all scared of something. You don't know how to contribute. That's okay. Learn. Change one line of code. Write one hot button. It doesn't matter. It's all out. And then just because he showed no pictures. I think this was earlier, I was having breakfast in Athens. This was us last year. I mean, as you can see, we're all looking sexy, mostly bald men. And this is the infamous Hugh, who's not here right now because he left us. But without him, I don't think half of you in this room would be here.
Computer, because then you can do work at the same time.
So please, so basically, you should never ask people to raise their hands because Shiny people are not. If you need them, never contributed to WordPress in any way, shape, or form. Okay, if I can convince all of you to join us tomorrow, this talk is amazing. Be it physically there or online above. As I said, we're 16 people, so if you want to bring friends or girlfriends or husbands or wives or living others or something on their dog, go ahead. I don't have a dog, will handle an office space, but I'm sure we'll be fine.
What time?
We're starting at 10 o'clock, but it's very flexible. We've got the space until 4, but I don't think we'll go on to 4, because I know our spec attorney would like to have some Saturday time. We will be having lunch at about 12:30. The beginning of the day will literally be... So, so the format for the day will be a brief introduction of all the different teams that exist and all of the people who are there who are experienced contributors that you can ask questions of. We will then give you time to find a seat, get your laptop sorted out, go onto the mental block, if you've never been there, help you get there, and read about all of the teams. Once you've read about all the teams, we're going to ask you to pick a team that you want to contribute to. Once you've done that, they will help you set up anything you need to set up, be it setting up site, be it setting up a development environment, be it getting access to a community team, a translations team, or whatever it is. Then at about 11:30, we'll start looking at, well, what do you want to start doing? What kind of help do you want to give? We'll break lunch at 12:30, and then if you go home at that point in time, I'm happy. If you want to then hang around for the afternoon, because if you do something with someone there to help you, great. And that will be the basic overview of that. It's very much hackathon style, very relaxed, very informal, just as I've dressed now. But if you can join us, please do. If you're a little bit late, you're going to get there at 12 for lunch and leave. I've got pizza coming for 15, and I've got 16 people who are ready to fight for me. Yes, sorry.
Where's the list of all the teams? I didn't get that little piece of paper.
Hang on.
And the team leads to that. Make.wordpress.org.
Make.wordpress.com.
Done. And it's in the middle of the same time because there's a spot in there which is really
expensive.
Is there parking? Yes. There is a parking. It's in the building. I believe we've got there parking for the people. So the parking is probably driving security and there's parking in the front. Because it's half a space, there won't be anybody using half a space parking. Okay, any other questions?
I've got a
screen
that works for
tech.
I think
that would be fine.
Yeah, I think we're going to call it. But before we do, I just want to say, from the organizing team, please, it's after Friday, but Friday, if you're still here, that's bloody amazing. Please give yourself.